everyone. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you the review of this book called Educated by Tara Westover. It's a memoir and it's the number one in New York Times bestseller list. This book is definitely surprised me because it's a memoir. And I always have a passion and love for memoirs since it's a real story about a prison. And it's really true about the real world, and I can learn a lot from their personal real stories. I like novel and fiction. A lot of times those stories have some logic issues or some unrealistic stuff within. Not a particular fit for today's society. And this book is really new. This book is published in 2018, only 2 years old. And I have to say, I really love this book. This book does give me a lot of insights into the personal story of Tara Westover. So this book talks about a girl called Tara Westover. And she grew up in Idaho with her family. Her parents have a lot of kids, and she is in the middle. And her childhood home is on a mountain with her family. Her family is really religious. They go to the church. They are calling themselves Mormons, which is a new word I just learned. And her father is a true believer of a catastrophe is happening. The story takes place in the 1990s up until the early 2000s, I believe. And inside there is a period she mentioned when the beginning of 2000, January 1st, her father actually believed that's the end of the world, and her family has prepared for the end of the world for a long, long time, for a lot of years already. Her family grew vegetables and fruits and put them in a jar to preserve them in their basement, just for anything would happen when the catastrophe hits. However, like we all knew, there were never a disaster. Her father doesn't believe the government, and her father believes self-sufficient. So her father bought a lot of cars, so her father have a lot of weapons and fire powers, just in case when the feds would invade them. So in the book, Tara mentioned when she was little, her father always tell her the story that some families who don't obey the government send their kids to public school instead of homeschooling, and the feds would come and trying to arrest the family. And her father tell her the story that the family hold on in their house against the feds, then and one child of that family ran away, and one parent follow that child, but eventually when they are in the forest, they were killed by the feds. So the point of her father's story is that to tell her, you had to be prepared against any governmental arrest and any government invasion of their home. They had to be self-sufficient enough to be last for several years. So in the book, they mentioned that their family has been prepared a long, long time for that moment to happen. And they have enough food and enough gun powers to hold inside their house for several years if the feds really came for them. So instead, the father never sent any of his kids to public school. Instead, her mother would just teach the children how to read and write in the home and learn some basic knowledge. Her family is also not a believer of hospitals. They are not a believer of public health system or the doctors. So instead, in the case of any medical service necessary, the mother is a herbologist. Her mother has a really good knowledge on the herbs and then those earth medicine. So in the case of some events when some people broke their legs or arms or even burn, her mother would mix some herbs as medicines for treatment. I remember when I read this book, there was one event when her father actually got burned. Because her father owned a junkyard full of cars. And a lot of daily jobs her father would take his sons to the junkyard to scrub from the old cars and trying to sell them for money. But in order to get something from those old cars, because some cars inside there is still some gas left over, you had to get the gas out first, otherwise you will be get hurt. However, there was one day her father forgot about it, and her father actually light up a car, which caused a big explosion, which caused a severe burn to her father. And her father refused to go to the hospital and he insisted that his wife treat him. His father's burn was pretty severe. He lied in bed for months and almost died at one point. However, in the event, her father consolidated the belief that the God is the only hope. Her father said the only reason he actually survived the burn is because that God gave him a second chance to be alive, to be a true believer of God. So after the burn, after her father recovered from the burn, he became more than before in believing God and not believing doctors and the government. And because of her mother's treatment for her father, and eventually her father actually recovered, although there are a lot of scars on his face. So when I read this book, it's really interesting to see a lot of the stories, because there are a lot of things I learned from that. And I learned from rural America, the family, and the belief of a non-government. So I would say her family's doing is pretty extreme, off the point. And father's non-belief is just a little bit ridiculous. Think about it. When your precious kids got hurt really bad, and the father refused to go to the hospital for any treatment, any official modern medicine treatment, and her father insisted to let her mother for any treatment and for many herbs and medicines. So since her mother doesn't have an official job, her mother usually just do house chores at home, mix herb medicines to sell, and even help to deliver babies who don't want to cost that money to go to hospital, or simply just like her family is not a believer of the public health system. Her mother actually delivered her own children. Her mother's children are not delivered by the hospital. Instead, all the siblings of her are delivered directly at home with some help from other women. And after that, her mother took the role and helped other mothers to deliver their children at home. And actually, in that rural town, a lot of people wanted that. And a lot of people want her mother to help them to deliver the baby. Well, the story begins when she and her siblings were really little. And eventually, through so many events, they eventually grow up. And I just want to say is how fascinating it is to see a girl actually grow up in such an extreme different environment than my own. To live and grow up in the rural America, be able to ride a horse whenever you want, and go to the mountain whenever you want, because it's just in your backyard of your house. Sometimes when I read the book, I would let my imagination fly to pursue happiness and to pursue the dream of living in a rural America without the city's hustle bustle, without so many noises, without so many cars, horn, and people talking every single day. I think I would love that, because the reality, I never had a chance of the true rural America, and I never had the chance of grow up in such environment. It's so fascinating to see her life growing up, which is so different from my own. Her father's health is not so great, and especially during the winter, her father would have a lot of issues. So a lot of years, whenever the winter hits, her father would drive the entire family to Arizona for warm weather, along with her grandparents. Just imagine how incredible it is to have a family trip, a family road trip every year to a different state to live for several months. I actually never had the privileges to do that. Usually, when I moved to a different place, I stayed there for usually as long as who knows what some events would happen. I feel like to have such a different environment to live in just because of the weather, just because of the season. It is so fascinating and interesting to me. And I truly wanted to do that. Since I live in Florida, all year round is hard summer. I really don't have the excuse to escape cold winter anymore. But in order to see the snow, I would love to go in the winter to some northern states, even some other countries, and to enjoy the snow, to enjoy the cold, the wind. And I honestly want to go snowboarding and skiing because I never done so. I want to ride those little cars up to the mountain and ski down the hill from the top of the mountain. It is so fascinating and amazing it is, isn't it? Well, this book does give me a lot of imaginations and a lot of dreams I want to pursue in. When she was little, she often helped her dad in the strip yard to collect some things or run some dangerous machineries. I mean, considering that for a little girl, it is so unbelievable for the people that grew up in a big city who never seen those big machineries before and who never actually worked in the real farm. I just couldn't believe a lot of things that she was writing in this book, and I have been so admired her bravery of all the things that she has done. She has a brother, an older brother named Sean, and Tara and Sean are pretty good buds. However, Sean has some abuse problems, and sometimes Sean would abuse Tara, and sometimes when he got really mad, he even beat Tara and push her head into the toilet. I mean, that's just so unbelievable for a brother to do that to his own little sister. I don't have any siblings, and I wanted some to see her big family and then her brother are treating such bad to her. I just couldn't believe, and I feel so sorry and sad for her. However, she stays strong, and eventually she even trying to tell her parents about it and other friends about it, even though her parents did not believe at all of what her saying, especially her dad. Her father was actually trying to let her to apologize to her brother for the wrong accuses. It is so wrong to think about it. And in the end, when she finally got out of home, following her big brother to go to an actually university to have a formal education, a higher education, a college education, she felt like she actually enjoyed that. So even though at the beginning she feels so out of the place, she doesn't have money, she dressed really poor, and she has nothing in common with other girls in the college, with the constant family support and a lot of money to spend on. She had to work in a local shop to earn some money, and sometimes even work for her dad to do some very dangerous tests just to earn some money enough to go back to the college. She had another semester of that. It is so unbelievable. Up until she got a chance from one of her professors in the college, in the university, that she actually has a chance to go to Cambridge to enjoy the top school of the world, to have good education, and eventually pursue a master's degree. It's incredible for such a rural girl that grew up in a small town to have such a big dreams, to pursue big dreams to achieve and visit the world, to explore how the entire world has to offer. It is incredible to read this book that to think about how amazing things work out for her. She actually went to Cambridge, and at the beginning she also felt out of place. She felt that she's not belong to that environment. However, she persevered and she insisted to have different life than her life from the mountain, away from the traffic, away from the world, away from the public education health system and the government. It is amazing to see how such ambition and how much she achieved. Well, Tara Westover grew up in that small town and homeschooling until she went to college. It is so incredible that she eventually went to Cambridge and Harvard to achieve such a higher education of the entire world that best has to offer. She is definitely my role model. And I truly believe she worked so hard and tried so much. And I'm so happy for her. One down thing about her life is that because she actually told her parents about her brother Sean's abuse, and her father and mother didn't even believe her. And her father wants her to apologize and say everything that she said is not real. But she couldn't lie. She couldn't just stay in the shadow forever. She spoke out for herself, and I'm so proud of her. Under the pressure of her parents want to separate from her, her father even told her that if you don't apologize to your brother, you're not my daughter. And up to until now, when she's older, and when she wrote this book, her parents and her are still not in the good terms. And I would wish they would get along eventually in the future. Well, I would say this book is definitely a huge hit. I actually have seen this book from my friends in my high school when it first published, or even in college. I just couldn't believe Tara Westover is just so amazing. And she persevered so much to grow up in a mountain state of Idaho where not much happening. Just surrounded by the big mountains and the woods and the animals. I would love a peaceful life like that. I would enjoy that. Maybe I would have to see myself because I have always been living in a big city, or rather the suburb of the big city. I never actually have the chance to be able to go and live in a truly rural town, to enjoy the wind, the grass, the mountain, to watch the sky and lie on the grass at night, to ride a horse, to go through the mountains, go through the field. It just seems so incredible and peaceful life. I personally am not a big city guy. I just love to have some peace in mind. I love the beach. I love the mountain. I love hiking. I love the nature. If I have a life like hers, I would bet it would be so different. Maybe I would actually enjoy to live in the mountain. Maybe I would actually enjoy to work in that scrapyard. But who knows? I personally am not a big believer of a big government either. So that this book definitely inspired to see how life would be when you don't believe the government. Well, there are definitely some ups and downs to think about your life. And I just feel so happy for her. One story is when the winter is over, when her family were in Arizona, and then her father wants to go back to home, go back to Idaho and work on her father's scrapyard and whatever her father was doing right then. Her father drove twice at night with a big wind and heavy rain, and her father crashed twice. It is so bizarre and so unfortunate, and I want to say not being cautious and not knowledgeable enough to drive cautiously and with license and insurance and everything, but because her father is not a believer of any of that, father doesn't have any of that. And father crashed twice, which one time because her mother was almost blind. Her mother stayed in their basement for several months, and the food would be brought down to the basement for her mother to eat. And I was so sad then to read about that. They were thinking that her mother might not ever be the same mother again, would never be able to do the same thing that she had done that before. However, her mother was so loyal to her husband that although her mother goes through so much, her mother would always back up her husband and would always try to agree and follow her husband. Well, it's either a good thing or a bad thing. Depends on what point you're thinking about, but it just feels like her mother is a role model and so strong, not only for her own kids and now for the rest of the world, to be able to endure such disastrous events and still got to endure such disastrous event and still got up so well, and eventually made her own business selling the herbs as a really popular medicine at that time. A memoir. It's amazing to see that how her life has been and how her experience has shaped of who she is. If I had the chance and the privilege, I would love to go for book signing if there is one anymore. I want to truly meet her and distance of how incredible word is, and how incredible that she's able to write most of her life up until this point in the book and show to the rest of the world of how her incredible life has been, and how she's able to persevere and endure all those hard moments to go through all of that and attain such a high education degree and have such a popular book. This memoir is definitely one of the must read. I have to say that I enjoyed so much reading. I have a habit of reading a book out loud. I feel like if I say every single word of the book, I would actually step into the realm of the book and I would actually participate the event of Tara Westover and to see her personal life growing up so incredibly detailed. I enjoy my time reading this book. It's just such a wonderful time that I have spent in the realm of her childhood, of her growing up with such hard endurances that she finally overcame all of that and be able to go through all of that and achieve so great. I would love to write a memoir like this someday as well, that I would truly want to show a lot of my experiences as well, that I can't wait to show the world. It just sometimes feels so different and I'm so desperate if I can ever live a different life. Imagine that I was a girl growing up in a mountain in the state of Idaho with a horse and grass and all the other animals. It would be so different, my life. That would be, I bet. It's just so different. The more books that I have read, I love them even more. I feel like reading a book is like live another life. It's not like a movie. It is a book. It's so incredibly detailed from every single moment, even up until the descriptions of the facial expression and the environment. Sometimes when you put your imagination out there, it just feels the world. It just feels that like you were living that world. And it's not like someone penned it for you and you would pen yourself. You would pen your own world with your mind just because of the word you read and the story that you hear. I have always been a lover of a good story. And I would say this book, Educated, is definitely of one of those stories that you have to experience yourself to truly appreciate. To truly enjoy that moment of being in that mountain and to see all different perspectives, all different point of views, and to have another life other than your own. Well, I'm definitely one of those individuals who are not 100% satisfied with my life right now, but I want to achieve more and achieve more greatness. And by reading this book, I feel like everything is possible because it just doesn't matter where you come from. It doesn't matter if you're from a rich family or a poor family. It doesn't even from if you are a big city or just a rural small town. You can achieve whoever and whatever you want it to be. It's just so amazing to see that everyone has such opportunities if you try hard enough, if you're doing the best that you possibly can. Well, I think that would conclude my review of this incredible book called Educated, and I would forever treasure this book in my life. And her story would always inspire me to do greatness and inspire me to achieve more, to dream big, to think more that I can possibly have. Thank you for watching, guys. See you next time. If you want to see more book reviews, I will post more. I have an incredible journey and a lot of fun to share this book with you guys. If you have any questions, please comment down below. I love to talk to you guys. See you next time. Bye.